The Wimpei Audiobook Series. Coiling Dragon, aka Panlong, by I Eat Tomatoes. Book 3, Mountain Range of Magical Beasts, Chapter 15, Cruelty. Within the mountain range of magical beasts, next to a spring, Lin Li dressed his wounds as he also began absorbing earth elemental essence to heal his wound. The ever-benevolent Mother Earth is always kind and selfless. Standing on the earth, Lin Li felt his wound slowly heal, filling his heart with peace. By now, Lin Li had already exchanged backpacks. His own backpack, in terms of both quality of leather and quality of workmanship, was far inferior to the assassin's. In addition, the assassin's backpack had an interior which was meticulously laid out. Once the lock was tightened, all of the items inside the backpack would be securely fastened, and the backpack itself would not impede movement in the slightest. And that assassin's black dagger was also extremely sharp, and Lin Li found that it was quite easy to wield. Whoosh! With a flicker, Lin Li's body moved, and he suddenly disappeared into the mountain forests. Lin Li didn't even bother to pay any attention to magical beasts of the first or second ranks. The most commonly seen beasts were of the third and fourth ranks. But if he ran into a magical beast of the fifth rank, Lin Li had confidence in at least giving them a good tussle. As he drew deeper and deeper into the mountain ranges, Lin Li encountered one bloody, cruel battle after another. He experienced many ambushes and assassination attempts. After all of these battles, the wounds and scars on Lin Li's body grew more and more plentiful as well, while Lin Li's spirit grew more and more tenacious. These life and death battles caused Lin Li's mind to become tougher, and his actions to become more merciless. In the blink of an eye, a month had passed since Lin Li had entered the mountain range of magical beasts. A month later, on top of a large tree located next to a mountain spring, there was a long scar on the left side of his face. Lin Li's back was arched, and he was hidden on top of the tree like a panther lying in ambush. Right now, Lin Li was hidden in the middle of many leaves, staring straight down at the ground. Just a few dozen feet away from the tree which Lin Li was hiding in was a small creek, and drinking water from the creek was a powerfully built bloodthirsty war pig. A single, blood-colored horn protruded out from above the war pig's nose, and muscles bulged throughout its body, like the gnarled roots of a tree. Bloodthirsty war pig, a magical beast of the fifth rank, fire element. This bloodthirsty war pig has a tough, thick skin. Its defensive abilities are exceedingly strong. Most likely, the earth and spear techniques wouldn't be able to penetrate its skin. Lin Li had a sudden insight, and began to formulate a plan. Immediately, his lips began to move silently as he soundlessly began to mouth the words to a spell. Slowly, the wind elemental essences around Lin Li began to swirl about him, forming into a bluish, translucent javelin in front of him. The translucent javelin's tip had gusts of wind flowing about it. Wind-style magic of the fifth rank, wind howl. Swish! A piercing sound could be heard as the wind howl javelin shot downwards with terrifying speed. At the same time, Lin Li jumped down from the tree's crown, leaping down with as much speed as the javelin. Upon hearing the noise, the bloodthirsty war pig stopped drinking water and stared up, but the wind howl javelin was simply too fast. In the blink of an eye, it traversed the distance and was only a few meters away from the war pig. The javelin's speed really was frighteningly fast, and its tip was covered with gusts of wind. Growling. The bloodthirsty war pig let out an angry howl, and it used the horn above its snout to strike viciously at the wind howl javelin. Crash! The javelin formed from the wind howl spell crashed directly onto the horn of the bloodthirsty war pig. The wind howl javelin immediately dissipated, but at the same time, after taking a hit from a spell of the fifth rank, the war pig couldn't help but half kneel from the force of the blow, with a bloody scar appearing on its forehead as well. Whoosh! Before the war pig had a chance to react, right behind the wind howl javelin was Linley, who with all his might, struck down at the center of the head of the war pig with his newly acquired black dagger. The dagger penetrated directly into the skull of the war pig, and as it did, Linley immediately dodged. Roar! Having been stabbed in a vital spot, the bloodthirsty war pig roared furiously. Flames began to arise on its body, and it also began charging forward with no regard for anything. But after rushing a few dozen meters, it collapsed. Its four legs quivered a few times before coming to a stop, and all of the fire on its body began to die as well. Amongst the magical beasts of the fifth rank, much like the vampiric iron bull, the bloodthirsty war pig is considered a beast of rather low intelligence. Linley walked to the corpse of the war pig, pulled out his dagger, and removed the magi side core from within the war pig's corpse. Thinking back to his recent life in the mountain range of magical beasts, Linley couldn't help but admit to himself that although he was still a magus of the fifth rank and a fighter of the fourth rank, his actual combat ability had increased tremendously compared to when he had first entered the mountains. After multiple life and death struggles, his body was covered with scars which symbolized painful lessons learned over this month. Especially on his chest, there was an extremely horrifying wound. That time, he really was at death's door. In the end, it was the little shadow mouse who once again saved the day. This wound wasn't given to him by a magical beast. It was given to him by an extremely adorable young lady. Back then, I really trusted her. I really believed that her friends had all been killed, and that the only one left was her, injured and alone. Thinking back to the events of 2 weeks prior, Linley once again felt a stab of terror. That girl had seemed so kind, so pure. When Linley discovered her, three other men and another girl had all died. Only she was left, filled with terror. Linley couldn't help but go comfort her, help her, take care of her. That girl had seemingly suffered a huge mental blow. Every night, she insisted that Linley hold her, as only in Linley's arms did she feel safe enough to go to sleep. Every night, upon seeing the peaceful look on her face as she went to sleep, Linley felt joy in his heart. 3 days passed in such a fashion. On the fourth night, she once again was sleeping quietly in Linley's bosom. But suddenly, this adorable girl pulled out a dagger and stabbed directly at Linley's chest, with Linley caught totally off guard. And then, the enraged bebe had suddenly, bizarrely, doubled in size. His enormous jaws bit off the girl's head with a single bite, immediately killing her. And then, Bebe returned to his normal size. But Linley couldn't staunch the flow of blood from the deep wound in his chest. In the end, the little shadow mouse, Bebe, was forced to use some special darkness-type magic techniques to close the wound. Back then, I should have listened to Grandpa Douring's advice. I lacked experience. Linley thought to himself and sighed. Originally, Douring Coward had warned him several times about the girl. In the end, Seeing that Linley was stubbornly set on assisting the helpless little girl, there was nothing the dowering coward could do. But he still tried to insist that even if Linley was going to help her, that he absolutely must not allow her to get near him. But at the time, the girl was extremely terrified, and wasn't able to fall asleep without Linley holding her. In the end, in order to comfort her, Linley held her in her arms, and they both went to sleep. I really didn't expect that her acting abilities would be so good. I treated her so well, but she could be so merciless to me. Linley sighed again in his heart. When that girl had stabbed him in the chest, he had seen the vicious look in her eyes, and his heart had grown cold. What had caused this girl to be so heartless and merciless? Could it be that despite taking care of her for 3 full days, she hadn't been moved in the slightest? Fortunately, thanks to Grandpa Dowering warning me over and over again, I didn't reveal Bebe's true capabilities to her. Linley couldn't help but admit that his life had been preserved thanks to Dowering Coward and Bebe. Linley, what are you thinking about? Are you thinking about that girl again? Dowering Coward appeared by Linley's side. Seeing the look on Linley's face, Dowering Coward was able to guess what he was pondering. That stab from the girl had injured Linley deeply, not just in the flesh, but also in his heart. From that day onwards, Linley no longer would easily trust others. From the very beginning, Dowering Coward had sensed that there were some problems with the girl. How could someone with the courage to enter the mountain range of magical beasts be so totally discombobulated by the sight of death? Unfortunately, Linley was still totally convinced by the girl's performance, and really felt that the girl was very pitiable. Linley, that girl's performing abilities was nothing. Back in my time, in the Poent Empire, I saw so many plots from enemy countries, plots which involved decades of subterfuge and lies which were totally undetectable. Their acting abilities are beyond your comprehension. Dowering Coward smiled faintly as he spoke. Remember, don't easily lower your guard when dealing with a stranger. Linley nodded slightly. Squeak, squeak. The little shadow mouse, Bebe, began to call out from next to Linley. Linley looked up. Right now, the little shadow mouse was leaping up and down atop the war pig's corpse. Boss, when are we gonna go to the central areas of the mountain range of magical beasts? Bebe mentally spoke to Linley in a somewhat unhappy tone. In this current area, the strongest creatures that we can meet are magical beasts of the 6th rank. They aren't much of a challenge. I want to challenge magical beasts of the 7th rank, boss. I want to challenge magical beasts of the 7th rank. Linley glanced at the little shadow mouse. That's enough. Don't get too cocky. You are bragging that magical beasts of the 6th rank are too easy? Do you remember that blue wind hawk from the other day? Was there anything you could do to him? That's not my fault. Bebe rubbed his head with his tiny paws as he said unhappily, Boss, you saw yourself. That blue wind hawk stayed in the skies and refused to come down. He just kept on throwing magical wind knives at us, as though they didn't cost him any mage force at all. I couldn't just let him attack me without end, could I? Linley laughed. Over the course of the past month, Linley had become very familiar with the little shadow mouse's abilities. In terms of speed, Bebe had reached a terrifying level indeed. But because he was physically small and only had his claws and teeth as offensive weapons, Although Bebe was capable of dealing with magical beasts of the sixth rank, he most likely would find it quite hard to deal with a magical beast of the seventh rank. Just at this moment, Linli suddenly frowned. He cautiously turned his head and saw a blurred human outline appear in the wilderness. End of chapter 15. Continue to book 3 chapter 16. Thank you for listening the audiobook series by Winpei. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for the new updates of audiobooks and games reviews. Love and peace. Winpei.